In Cuba, just 2 hours from the capital of Havana, visitors would normally find a distinctly agricultural landscape of valleys where farmers grow high-quality tobacco for the iconic Cuban cigar. But more than 1 week after the tobacco industry took a direct hit from Category 3 Hurricane Ian, the region is still without power and is growing in frustration among farmers, a mood that contradicts the government's narrative that the island is returning to normal. In Pinar del Rio, farmers would be planting the next tobacco crop, but instead, they're trying to find shelter and care for their family, their tobacco fields and livelihoods shredded by Hurricane Ian. Patrick Altman reports.
The further west you go from Havana, the worse the damage gets. Hurricane Ian plowed into rural Pinar del Rio province as a Category 3 storm. Days later, people carry their rain-soaked mattresses to dry in the sun. Pieces of someone's roof still hangs from a tree. Some residents have that faraway look, unable to believe their eyes. This is what tobacco grower Hiroshi Robina's farm looked like the last time we visited him. After Ian, Hiroshi Robina's farm is unrecognizable. Here we've lost everything, he says. All the infrastructure to produce tobacco has been destroyed. There's no house to dry the tobacco or the warehouse. Nothing. There's nothing left. Hurricanes are part of life in Cuba. But residents here say Ian developed so quickly they did not have time to prepare. Hiroshi is just telling me that his grandfather, Alejandro, one of the most famous tobacco growers in Cuban history, built this tobacco curing house in 1944. It survived every hurricane up until now. Ian knocked out Cuba's already weakened electrical grid. The first time a storm has taken down power for the entire island. Frustrated by the blackouts, protests have broken out. Ileana tells me she has gone for 6 days without power and wants solutions, not explanations from officials. After days and days without power, the situation in this neighborhood is now boiled over. People have come out to the street to protest, yelling Libertad, freedom. Counter-protesters have now come in and they're yelling Viva Fidel, long live Fidel Castro. Cuba's president called the protests illegitimate and said that officials were working around the clock to restore power. Getting the lights back on in hard-hit Pinar del Rio could take weeks or months, officials say. This is the region where much of the tobacco that is rolled into Cuba's famed cigars is grown. Hiroshi says usually he would be planning now for the upcoming harvest. Plans wrecked by Ian. I don't think there's going to be a harvest, he says. It's unfortunate, but it's going to take months to clean this up and months to rebuild. As a fifth-generation tobacco grower, Hiroshi says he has no choice but to start from scratch. But many here who have been knocked down by the storm may never get back up. Patrick Ottman, CNN, Pinar del Rio Province, Cuba.